It's Big Jim Country Boy here at my secret cabin where I do secret things sometimes in the mountains. We're going to go over here and we're going to cook up some vittles with our cast iron Dutch oven. So let's get going on that.
Stop it.
Hey, thanks for watching, everybody. Big Jim Country Boy here on YouTube. Today we're going to make Texas chuck wagon steak is what I call this recipe I made. And we're going to make that in this large Dutch oven here. And then the first thing we need to do is start this recipe off is I have my trusty coffee pot here. And we're going to brew up a little coffee. What do I got here? I brought a little scoop of coffee. I got one of them scoopers that like you get in a can of iced tea. I don't know what size it is. 2-3 tablespoons, maybe quarter cup. But I put that in here. I don't know if you ever saw one of these. It's a percolator coffee maker. It's great for the power outages or camping and whatnot. We're going to put that on here and get that to percolate. So that's ice cold spring water, so that's going to take a while. And then that'll give us some time to burn these coals down on this fire when we put our Dutch oven on here to cook the steak. This is just a ring with legs I made. I used to have a big round slab of cut sawmill wood on here. It was an end table on my patio, but the wood started to get rotted and we burned it on a fire one time. So I brought the ring up here to the campsite. We use it like this. I got an old rack off of an old barbecue grill, one of their propane jobbers, and I put that on here to grill on and whatnot sometimes. And you see all my cast iron I got out now. I don't leave it out here, but when I come out to cook, all the rain was through this morning. Nighttime I got that big wooden box trunk and I bring it in the cabin when we're done cooking and what. But we use it for breakfast and lunch and dinner, and it's seasoned well. Sometimes I leave it out overnight. But it's getting a little cooler at night this time of year, so there's always a dew or a little shower. So I've been bringing it into the cabin at night. Hey, look, here comes little Jim Country Boy. I lost my hole. There it is, my holder. Running back to the cabin for a couple chairs, son?
Yeah.
All right. Black cherry. Flavored sparkling beverage with other natural flavors. Clear America from Walmart.com. So we're going to sit here and just wait for the coffee, move it around sometimes to get the fire right under it. That should take a little bit. So I think we'll pause here while we wait for the coffee to start cooking. Maybe I can put some more wood on there, split some of this up smaller. brought chickens up here a while back. I don't know if you saw our chicken videos. And we left them out with a rooster or two. And it's pretty funny, they lay eggs up here. And they hatch little ones all on their own and everything. They're like wild chickens around the cabin here now. I just wished I would never do it. Or I just wish I would have never did it though, because I gotta listen to them crow all the time. It's so peaceful up here. And I like to listen to the wild birds, but they're not around much. When the rooster crows, they're quiet. You don't hear much out of them. If the rooster's quiet, it almost sounds like we're in a jungle or a rainforest or something, all the different birds you hear. Everybody keeping up with the fake news on TV? These major networks, they should be arrested. Everything they say is a bunch of lies. I get all my news off of YouTube. I don't watch that fake news or them lies on these major cable TVs and networks. I don't subscribe to Dish TV of any kind, or cable, or nothing like that. I stream everything now. Get the truth off of Netflix, or get the truth off of YouTube instead of this fake news on these cable and Dish subscriptions. They rob you, cost too much anyway. I see there our commander-in-chief got the bovine 19. He'll be fine. Well, we got a fire going now, just so you can get that coffee to cook. See what I mean? Now those roosters are going to start fighting each other, see who's louder. Maybe we'll have to do another chicken pot pie soup or another chicken soup video. Sounds like we're going to have to make another chicken soup video. Leave a comment down below if you think we should make another chicken soup video. My knees. I've been playing with the fire, pushing stuff around and shaking it a little bit like this. If you look here, this see the coffee starting to boil. Gets a little darker there, percolating there. We'll get her started here. We'll get our Texas Chuck Wagon steak going. It's actually Texas Chuck Wagon Chuck Steak. We're using chuck steak from the steer we got butchered. And then you can see that bubbling in there now in that lid, that clear cap. You just let that go until it gets to the darkness of the coffee that you would like. Bring it back here a little bit. We don't want to boil too hard. Pump all the grounds up like it's doing into the coffee. Well, that coffee is doing pretty good. What we're doing with this coffee is I do this when I make like beef or venison. When you want that nice rich brown broth or brown gravy, coffee along with like salt and garlic and bay leaf and onion powder and garlic powder. We use some seasoned salt. You'll see in a minute, we got a whole spice bag we already mixed up at home and brought with us camping. Instead of bringing all the spice rack with us, we just put what we're going to use, like black pepper and whatnot, with the other things I just mentioned, in a little Ziploc sealed bag, zipper sealed bag. So, we'll get on our way here with the recipe now. But that's what that coffee's for. We're going to put that right in, as you'll see. Grab the trivet here. Don't want to scorch my pretty blue table cover. Time of year, the leaves keep falling on it and ashes from the fire, of course. I remembered my insulated leather gloves this time. Suggest you buy a pair if you're going to do this. And this is just a barbecue grill rack I set on there, like I said. Careful, the glove will get hot and burn you too. Get our old tripod out here. Thank you. think that'll stay. Kind of not right where I want it to. I think that's better to work. Send it over the wire. I'm just guessing here. I always hook the other end up so it don't get down in the fire, in the way, or in the pot. We're using our big 12 inch today. I just want to check the height here before I go too far. That looks about right, maybe. Maybe a little higher later. Some sliced potatoes and some baked carrots already packaged up. We do most of our prep work at home before we come. We're going to line the bottom of the pan with that. The reason I do it this way is if something burns, it's going to be the potatoes or the carrots, rather than an expensive piece of meat or even a cheap piece of meat. So that's what we got so far. Got our chuck wagon steak here. Try to do this without making a bloody mess. I like to do is just cut most of the bag and then not all. And then in here we got some nice big steaks. Boneless chuck steak from this steer that we got butchered. It's probably close to 3 pounds of chuck steak here, total. You just want to layer that over top of the potatoes and carrots. Layer it over the potatoes and carrots. This goes together. It's assembled almost like a lasagna. Pack it in, pack it out. And then in here, we have peppers, onions and mushrooms already sliced. And what we want to do is space the mushrooms out on top of the steak first. Unless you don't like mushrooms, then you can leave it out. But that's what you can do when you cook. Make it way you like it. I got my onions here already sliced. Peppers already cut up and sliced out of our garden. So then we're going to spread the peppers around the top too. Try to get a piece of pepper over everything. evenly distributed, like you're doing a lasagna or on top of a pizza. And as this cooks, these juices out of these peppers and onions cook down in and season the meat and the mushrooms. You could add eggplant, squash, whatever you have on hand or whatever you like. But this goes really good with peppers and onions and the chuck steak. The potatoes and carrots are on the bottom where all the juices are going to go down in and flavor that. Plus, we're going to have a broth in here, don't forget. Coffee's going to go on here. I just like breaking the onions up a little bit. And then you leave that on top. You could do this in a crock pot, electric Dutch oven. You could roast it in the oven in a roasting pan if you wanted. That's what we look like so far. Mushrooms, peppers, then onions on top of the steak with the potatoes and carrots on the bottom. And then we have here our little bag of tricks. Onion powder, garlic powder, black pepper, seasoned salt, and a bay leaf. Now, I always like to get my bay leaf down alongside the pot, way down the bottom in the broth, because the way the flavor comes out of there is if it boils in the water or simmers in the water, almost like a tea. You sprinkle some of this around the top. We got about a quarter teaspoon of each. But like I said, you can make it to your taste, how you like it. And then we have our coffee here. Try not to rinse all the spices down, but just about half of them. Take our lid.
It smells good already.
Yeah, it does. The peppers, onions, and garlic and coffee smells like stew already. It's not going to be like a stew though. It's going to make that tough cut of meat. It's going to make that tough cut of meat very tender. That's where she's going to set for a while, and then we're going to check it periodically, of course. It shouldn't burn too easy with that liquid in there. We poured almost that whole pot of coffee in there. There's probably a cup left, that's it. My tongs here. I use these a lot to move the fire around, reposition wood to make more heat and whatnot. Our stick of wood in over here. Keep the heat rolling. Thank little Jim Country Boy here for hauling all the wood up the hill here to the campsite.
If you're doing this with charcoal, you put some on the bottom and you also put some on the lid, but since we're hanging it over the fire,
yeah,
it's not really needed.
And you're going to boil from the bottom with the water and the steam's going to come up anyway. You really don't need to put nothing on the lid. It's just more nuisance to clean that off without dumping it in your food. if you were baking something, yeah. Or making pizza. But there it is. That's got to cook for a while. We'll be back after it's got some cooking time, and I'll let you know just about how long when the time comes. Fire's dying down a little bit here, but we want to cook this slow so it's tender. We take a leak there, a look in there, you can see it's nice broth and it's still boiling good, slow simmer, as long as we keep that lid on there. I think it's time we put our log on the fire here. Big Jim Country Boy decided to go over to the lake, see if he could catch a couple crappie or some sunfish or something. Yeah, little Jim Country Boy decided to go over to the lake, do some fishing. I got one of them nifty laser thermometers. I think it's in the cabin or the car. I'm going to try to find that, because that'll tell me how hot the pot is. If you hit the lid, it'll pretty much tell you what the temperature inside the pot is, I think. Yeah, I gotta see if I can find that. That laser thermometer, I think it's in the cabin. That'd be a nice handy tool for cooking like this. Nice hack. I mean, it's all a guessing game otherwise. How do you tell how hot that is? I suppose you could put a thermometer in the liquid, but then you gotta open it up and let the heat out and everything too. A little cloudy with overcast today. It's supposed to clear off. I hope it does, but it's starting to look like we might get a little rain. Thank God them stinking roosters finally walked off somewhere and went quiet. They get into these where they just keep howling and howling and crowing and crowing. I don't know, maybe they lost the hens, like got separated in the woods, and then they start crowing all the time. Then other times like this, everything's quiet for some reason. You don't hear anything. The crickets were even quiet. They just started going off now. I guess they're crickets. Sounds like I hear some kind of bugs. You can barely hear any birds or anything out in the distance. It's real quiet here for some reason now. Of course, except for my big mouth flapping. My gopher's fishing, so
going to pause here for a minute. I'm going to run into the cabin, take a peek out the window in the back porch of the cabin. I can see the lake. It's just over the hill. So I'm going to holler to Jim. And I got to get some plates and stuff like that from the cabin so I can plate this up here at the end of the video so you can see what it looks like too. But I'm going to look for that thermometer, see how that laser thermometer works,
what kind of temperatures we're talking about. I'll be right back. I'll pause it till then. I couldn't find my laser thermometer. Jim gets here, I'll ask him if he knows where it's at. I might have took it home and left it at home. It could be anywhere. Between the camper and here and the cabin, here and home and in the pickup or the car. I don't know.
See how we're looking here. Looking good. Simmer nice and easy for us. Looks like the fire's dying down though. Weather's been nice and cool lately out here. I like it. I think the high today is supposed to be like 65 or something.
How's it
hey,
looking?
It's gotten there pretty good. Catch any fish?
No, I lost the only lure I brought with me.
Oh, that's why you're back, huh?
Yeah, and that, and right after I lost the lure, I lost the screw that holds the crank on there.
But maybe we got another fishing reel at home we can fix that with. Put it on there with a rivet or a little nut and bolt or something. That's a shame. This is a good little telescoping rod here. We got this at Walmart. Walmart.com. It's a pretty handy pole. Doesn't take up a lot of room in your pack or anything like that. Big Jim Country Boy will fix it for you, son. How's it looking? Hey! I was back at the cabin there when I yelled to you. I was looking for my laser thermometer. You ain't seen it, have you? Do you know where it's at?
No, I thought the last time we were up here we left it here, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, I thought so too. I looked in the car in the pickup real quick. And I looked through the cabin, I couldn't find it. I thought it'd be nice to check the temperature on the pot. Because it could be cooling down right now, we don't know.
Right, right.
Why don't you go run in the cabin quick? Grab me another one of them black cherries or something.
Okay.
Or one of those flavored seltzer waters or something. And just don't spend a lot of time. I'm thirsty. But real quick, see if you can find that laser thermometer and then come back with my drink.
All right.
Don't spend a lot of time looking, Jim.
Okay.
30 seconds, maybe. If you think you know where it's at, go look.
All right.
like the 4th of July. Now the wind's gonna change directions and smoke me out. Might get eaten by a bear or something. I'll smell like jerky walking around. Oh, I guess it's time to move my chair. Right here. Now smoke coming this way again. Steel Junior's chair. That's better. This Texas Chuck Wagon steak's been cooking about 3 hours now. I think she's about done. I think she's about done there, son. Get myself whistle wet here. Whistle wet here. I had to move to your chair. I was getting smoked out. I smell like beef jerky. A bear or something will be after me. Put the lid on the trivet. Smells good. Smell through the pot. I think that's the fire. Ooh, that does smell good. Peppers, onions, a couple pieces of mushroom. Don't worry about that, it's cooked.
more onions and peppers, a couple mushrooms. Some meat.
This was my idea. This is one of my favorites.
So tender, I hardly need a knife. It's like breaking apart. This knife looks like it's razor sharp, but it's really not. Potatoes are nice and tender. I should have had a spoon. They're falling apart. Look at that.
Usually about the time to
grab the tongs, son. Maybe the tongs will work.
Usually when your potatoes are done like that, your meat's done by then too.
Yeah. I think it was probably done 30 minutes ago. Before we dig in and eat, we grab this camera and take you over for a closer peek. Look at that. Boy, that looks delicious. I can't wait to taste it. Boy, this looks good, son. The potatoes taste like meat. That's that coffee and that bay leaf. How tender that chuck steak is. My knife's over there on the table yet. Look, I got a fork.
The mushrooms you can taste like meat.
Cut it with a fork. This is very good. The same thing on a grill. We've done it on a grill. You cut the vegetables real large, thick, and pile them on the steak. The fire low, around 250, 300, and close the grill. I don't know if you ever eat chuck steak before, but that's tender when you can cut it with a fork.
You cook it the wrong way, your leather shoe or boot might be a little bit more easier to eat.
That's good. I ain't nothing like this, Jim, since I made that country ham. You should look for that video after this one. That's a really good video.
The best part about this is when everything tastes like the gravy and everything, it gets nice and thick in there because it cooks down, and the onions are flavored all the same, the peppers, it all gets a real nice warm flavor.
It tastes like steak too. It don't taste like a pot roast, even though it was cooked like similar. Tastes like steak.
Even the mushrooms taste like steak. I mean, you cook them with anything, they taste like what you cook them with.
You could make this with lamb or pork, venison, any kind of meat you have, really. Rabbit gets a little dry, like turkey or chicken, if you cook it too long. I bet chicken thighs would be good like this. I like to grab a piece of pepper and a piece of onion and then stab a piece of steak. It almost tastes like them shish kebabs you make in the summer.
I give it a 20 out of 10.
You're easy to please.
Yeah.
It is very good though. I don't know about you, son, but now I'm getting sleepy. I think I might have to head back to the cabin and take a nap while you clean up.
All right. Sounds like a plan.
Boy, that was good. Put my plate up there too, Sonny?
Sure.
Put the lid on that. Pass me that drink there. I left these bother me. Thank you, sir.
Probably from all that hair or chair hopping from the fire.
Packing all this crap up from the car to the cabin. Packing everything from the cabin today up to here. I'm not exactly a hiker. Of course, I have done some hiking though. You should check out my other videos where we go hiking. We traveled all around the United States with our camper last year.
Refresh my memory, where does this one hang up over here?
On the left over there where there's lines going. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the recipe. I hope you try it. You're always welcome. welcome to follow my recipe, share it, but I hope you give it your own personal twist to your liking. And I hope you share it with your friends on social media. And if you didn't already, subscribe and ring that bell for notifications when we get a new. Time to head into the cabin maybe and take a nap now.